organizing secretary, because many of us typing the correct answer, who was the first woman freedom fighter of India. Maximum number of participants answer Velu Nachiyar. Correct answer. Apart from faculty members of history department, most of us thought that Rani Lakshmibai was the first queen fought against the British rule, but it is not correct. According to military consultancy records, inscription of Siddhi Vinayagar Temple, Rajayan South Indian Rebellion mentioned Velu Nachiyar ruled Sivaganga in 1780s. Even before Jhansi Rajni's period, 77 years ago, Velu Nachiyar had started fighting against the British colonial power in India to defend her state. Based on source, we have no doubt Velu Nachiyar was the first female freedom fighter of India. Okay, now let's go to the topic. In the early period, first one of the female freedom fighter, Velu Nachiyar. Velu Nachiyar was considered the first woman of Tamil origin to challenge the British Empire. She was an 18th century queen from Sivaganga. She was well trained in warfare at her young age. The allies of British and Nawab of Arcot invaded against Sivaganga. That time, Velu Nachiyar's husband, Muthu Vadaganathan, ruled in Sivaganga. In the Battle of Kalayar Koil, Muthu Vadaganathan was killed by British army in 72 AD. The invading forces plundered the town. Nawab of Arcot, appointed as the representative of British at the time, the name Sivaganga was changed as Husain Nagar. Velu Nachiyar asked the help from Hyder Ali. Velu Nachiyar and her daughter Velachi Nachiyar and her minister got aside from Hyder Ali. She was well known Urdu. She explained to him her strong opposition of British rule. Hyder Ali accepted and provided the military equipments to Velu Nachiyar. Later, they were joined there by Madhu brothers. After getting the full support, Velu Nachiyar returned from Dindigul to Sivaganga. She prepared different groups of army. She used boomerangs in warfare. She trained her army in the art of warfare to the Udayal women forces under the captainship of Kuili. She was an adventurous woman. In 1780, the British army's captains were Pancho and Joseph Smith. They planned to attack Velu Nachiyar's army from the British armory. Their weapon storehouse was behind the palace of Sivaganga. Kuili heard the news. She decided to secure Velu Nachiyar. She applied, he set herself, applies and jumped into the armory of the British, securing victory for Velu Nachiyar. Velu Nachiyar's army entered Sivaganga. British representative Nawab lost control over Sivaganga. Velu Nachiyar's allies successfully quashed the British and recaptured her kingdom. She captured and called renamed Sivaganga. Velu Nachiyar captured the throne and Marudu brothers act as ministers of resettlement of Sivaganga. Velu Nachiyar ruled it for over 10 years. She became the first revolutionary who opposed the rule of British in Tamil Nadu. Kuili is considered the first human suicide bomber. This patriotic young woman, who was a human bomb, sacrificed her precious life for the freedom of her motherland from British rule. Tamil Nadu government built a memorial for Kuili. It is located at Sivaganga. These brave women's history never found in history texts. With the exception of Tamil Nadu, both women are unknown across the country, despite their warfare tactics against the British in the 18th century. This slide shows a memorial for Quili. It is located at Sivaganga. Then is one of the female freedom fighter, Kittu Rani Chennamma. She was the queen of the princely state Kittu in Karnataka. She was proficiently trained in horse riding, sword fighting, and archery from her young age. She got married to Raja Mallarudrasa of Kittur. After losing her husband and son, had to take over the responsibility of her kingdom. The British tried to confiscate the treasure and the jewels of Kittur. Also, they were wanted to capture Kittur. Chennamma led an army rebellion at the age of 33 in 1824. British attacked with a force of 20,709 men and 437 guns, mainly from the 3rd Troop of Madras Native Horse Artillery. Chennamma fought fiercely but was ultimately captured and imprisoned at Peilhongal Fort. She could not succeed in the war but did evoke the fire of freedom in everyone's heart. This is the image of Chennamma. The next slide, Avanti Bai. We all know about Rani Lakshmibai of Jhansi, but not many know about another such lion-hearted lady, Avanti Bai. She was married to King Vikramaditya Lodi of Ramkar. It was a princely state. She was well-trained in sword fighting, archery, cavalry, military, and diplomatic strategies. When Vikramaditya fell into ill health, it was Avanti took over the foreign reign of Ramkar's administration. After the king's death, she actively took part in the revolt of 1857. Because the doctrine of labs under which Dalgowsi wanted her to surrender Ramkar. We are from history department. All of us knows about doctrine of labs. She decided to fight against British rule to save her state. For that, she made a next step to ask the help with neighboring rulers. She was sent urgent emissaries to the rulers of neighboring kingdoms to join her in the war against British subjugation that were accompanied by a set of bangles. In their strongly worded letters, if you think you have a duty towards our enslaved motherland, raise your swords and jump into the war against the British. Otherwise, wear these bangles and hide yourself in houses. By 1857, entire region had joined the armed rebellion. During the battle, who was the captain of British? General Waddington. General Waddington surrounded her army in Ramkar. She was defeated and captured by British. She chose to sacrifice her life rather than to surrender to the enemy. She healed herself with her own sword on 20th March 1858. She had never liked to be a prisoner of British. Avanti Bai's role was slowly erased from history books in recent years, gradually coming to public attention. The next one of the female freedom fighter, Begum Ghazarat Mahal. She was one of the most pivotal characters during the 1857 Indian Rebellion, who fought against the rule of the British East India Company. Begum Ghazarat was the second wife of Bayazid Ali Shah of Aur. It was a princely state. Lord Dalgowsi wanted to annex Aur through the policy of doctrine of labs. When the British had taken over Aur and her husband was exiled to Calcutta, Begum Ghazarat took charge of the affairs in the state of Aur. She was a brave and a powerful lady. She organized an army of women under the command of Uda Devi. Begum Kasara motivate the masses to rebel against the British East India Company. She inspired and urged them to fight in the freedom struggle. When the British attacked out, both Uda Devi and her husband were part of the armed resistance. When she heard that her husband had died in the battle, Uda Devi unleashed her campaign in full force. Begum Kasara fought with British. People of Oud supported her completely. She fought bravely to reclaim Oud from the British. She made her son Birgis Watts the ruler of Oud. Begum Kasara known as the Lakshmi Bai of Oud. Her role in the revolt of 1857 is often ignored by the current generation. However, her name got erased out of the thin pages of history. Then next one of the freedom fighter, Jalgari Bai. Jalgari Bai was an important role in the Indian freedom movement. Extremely courageous woman. She was a woman soldier who played an important role in the Indian rebellion of 1857. She served in the women's army of Rani Lakshmi Bai of Jhansi. She was a prominent advisor to the queen. Once she had an encounter with a tiger in the jungle and killed it with her axe. Jalgari Bai was the one who played a very crucial role in the Battle of Jhansi. During the siege of Jhansi, General Huck Rose was captain of British Army. When the situation was not favorable, Rani of Jhansi decided to leave the fort. Originally a peasant woman, but not now a soldier, offered to disguise herself as the Rani Lakshmi Bai and to command the army. She took a small unit of soldiers and left from the front door. Jalgari was recognized by a traitor. She fought at the front, allowing the queen escape safely out of the fort. She plunged herself into the battlefield to confront the British. Jalgari secured Lakshmi from the siege of Jhansi. But before dying, she had killed a number of British soldiers. Jalgari's role was feared in the revolt of 1857. The next slide. From 1920s to 1940s, what were the elements of participated in the freedom movement, particularly answer female freedom fighters. During the period, we all know about Sarojini Naidu, Kasturi Bai Gandhi, Vijayalakshmi Pandit, and Annie Besant in the 20th century, who made it into history books for their contribution. These women have found a place in the pages of history. Several women have remained. When Gandhiji started the non-violent, non-cooperation movement, he was convinced without women could not successfully continue. He called upon and welcomed to join the Indian National Congress and to take part in the freedom struggle. He wrote, "I expect great things from the women. I accept them to do their full share in the struggle." Thus, at the call of Gandhiji, women began to join the Indian National Congress. This slide shows Arunav Ashapalli. The women's studies books also mentioned about Arunav Ashapalli. I'd like to remember here, who was the grand old man of India? All of us know Dadabhai Nauroji. At the same time, never heard of her, known as the grand old lady. She is, Arunav Ashapalli is known as the grand old lady of the independence movement. She participated Salt Satyagraha, Quit India movement. Then she was elected the first mayor of Delhi in 1958. This slide shows the image of Arunav Ashapalli. The next one of the female freedom fighter, Pikaji Kama. Yesterday's session, Professor Thangam mentioned about Pikaji Kama, even though I want to tell a few words about her role. She was one of the prominent figures in the Indian independence movement. Kama was born in Mumbai in a very well-to-do family. At the age of 23, she was married to Rustan Kama, but was not happy in her marriage. She spent her most of the time in philanthropic activities and social work. She was not just a part of Indian independent movement, but Kama was also a strong supporter of gender equality. As an Indian ambassador, she also traveled to participate in the international conference in Germany in 1907. The International Socialist Congress held at Stuttgart, Germany in 1907. On 22nd August 1907, Pikaji Kama became the first person to hoist Indian flag on foreign soil. She advocated for women's rights, who had the unique distinction of unfurling the first version of the Indian national flag, a tricolor of green, saffron, and red stripes. 1,000 of representatives from across the world had come to attend the conference. Kama beguiled and says, "The flag of independence India is born. It has been made sacred by the blood of young Indians who sacrificed their lives in its honor. In the name of this flag, I appeal to lovers of freedom all over the world to support this struggle. The fierce lady then announced, this is the flag of independent India. I appeal to all gentlemen to stand and salute the flag." For her bold activities, the British arrested and imprisoned in Andaman jail. We have no doubt Pikaji Kama was one of the patriotic revolutionaries. The next slide shows Bogeshwari Pukanani. One more example of martyrdom that went unnoticed was from the district of Nagpur in Assam. Quit India movement inspired many women from different parts of India to fight in the freedom struggle. Pukanani was a gallant lady. She had 8 children. She encouraged her children to participate in the freedom movement. When the time of Quit India movement, Pukanani actively participated in the local protest against the British authorities. The Bhartapur office of the Indian National Congress had been seized by the British. The revolutionaries took back control of the office. British government sent military forces to take revenge. At the time, a crowd came marching from the nearby village with the flag and shouting Vande Mataram. This crowd was led by Bogeshwari. Captain Finnish snatched that flag from the revolutionaries, fell down on it. Pukanani snatched the flag from his hand and hit his head with pole of the flag. Captain Finnish immediately fired on Bogeshwari Pukanani, who fell down to the crowd shouting Vande Mataram. She succumbed to the injuries, died on 20th September 1942. She renowned as the 60-year-old martyr. The next one of the female freedom fighter, Ganga Devi. Ganga Devi from Uttar Pradesh had no formal education. She got married to a government employee at the age of 13. Her family was a big family, which had over 60 family members. Gandhiji's principles inspired her. She wanted to participate in the national movement. But her family not allowed, even though she saved money from the household expenses and cooked food for revolutionaries in hiding while her husband was asleep. Washing utensils herself to keep the matter a secret, even from family members. In her family situation, she helped something to revolutionaries. Next, another one of the female freedom fighter, Kamala Devi Satodbaya. Many of us know about, so I skip the slide. Then next one of the freedom fighter, Kanaklada Parwa. She was born in Assam. She was one of the greatest, various and youngest freedom fighters from Assam. Her dream was to serve the country in the independence struggle. She joined in the Quit India movement started by Indian National Congress from Assam. Sir, mute that mic. Sir, hello, sir, is there audible? Hello, sir, I continue. Shall I continue? So shall I continue?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, sir. She aimed to hoist the flag at the British-dominated Kokpur police station. During the Quit India movement, while marching to hoist the Indian flag in Assam, she was shot dead. So next, Kolkata female freedom fighters. Kindly one announcement. Dear friends, kindly post your queries in chat box. End of the session, I will clarify that answer. Okay? Come to the point. Everybody knows the name of Kalpana Datta from Kolkata. Several women who actively participated in the Indian freedom struggle. The West Bengal State Archives has unearthed 173 women who actively participated in the freedom movement during the early part of the 20th century from Bengal. Among them, 11 were from Kolkata. They were Kalpana Datta, Kalyani Das, Kamala Satarji, Ila Sen, Leela Rai, Leela Vedi Verma, Prabhavadi, Dash Gupta, Sujata Datta, Sulata Kar, Leela Kumble, who were all convicted for participating in the freedom movement from 1920s to 1940s. Some were imprisoned. These women never found a place in the history books or became two topics or research of a scholar. They are the unsung heroines of Indian movement. The next one of the unsung female freedom fighter, Madangani Hashra. She was from Kolkata. She was a staunch Gandhian and a supporter of non-cooperation movement. She, at the age of 73, was also an active participant of the Quit India movement, leading the procession of 6,000 supporters. Most of them were women to confiscate the Tamluk police station. During the procession, the police fired to the crowd. She continued her march with the national flag, repeating the slogan, Vande Mataram, till her last breath. Kolkata government erected a statue for her. The first statue of a woman was put up in Kolkata. She played a significant role in the Quit India movement. But in today's era, her name is unheard. Her contribution was lost in the pages of history. Another one of the unsung heroine, Moolmadi. We all know about Ram Prasad Bismil. At the same time, Moolmadi's sacrification was not found in the history texts. She was the mother of freedom fighter Ram Prasad Bismil. Bismil formed the Hindustan Socialist Republican Association in 1928 along with Bhagat Singh. She supported and helped her son in his struggle for freedom. Bismil was arrested for Mainpuri conspiracy case of 1918 and the Kakori conspiracy of 1925, who was hanged by the British Raj for his role. After the death of her son Bismil, she took a bold step. She also addressed a public gathering and offered and raised her other son's hand to the freedom movement. it is always due to such brave mothers of India. Another one of the unsung heroine, Parvati Giri, a prominent brave heart from Odisha who played a significant role in the Indian freedom struggle. She was born in Sambalpur. She was just 16 when she was in the forefront of agitation. Following Mahatma Gandhi's Quit India call, she participated in the Quit India movement and arrested and imprisoned for 2 years. She trained villagers, teaching them how to spin and weave khadi. She opened an orphanage at Paikmal village and devoted the rest of her life for the welfare of orphans. Parvati Giri is known as the Mother Teresa of Western Odisha. The next one of the slide shows Tara Rani Srivastava. She was born in Patna. She got married at the age of 13. Her husband, Pulandu Babu, and she actively participated in the Quit India movement with Mahatma Gandhi. During the protest, Pulandu soon fell to police bullets, but Tara Rani was not stopped the procession. Their aim to hoist the national flag and its roof of Shivan police station. She bandaged his wounds, then she marched with the national flag straight towards the police station. By the time she returned, her husband has died. She was devoted, patriotic. Later, she continued to be the part of the freedom struggle until the partition of India on 15th August 1947. The next one of the freedom fighter, Susheta Kripalani, in women's studies books also mentioned about her. I know all of us about her role, so I skip the slide. The next one of the unsung female heroine, Usha Mehta. She was born in Gujarat. Her family settled in Mumbai. She actively participated in the freedom struggle from Mumbai. Gandhian principles inspired her immensely. At the tender of 8, she participated in a protest march against the Simon Commission. Later, she established a radio station that was the Secret Congress Radio. The Secret Congress Radio conveyed messages from Gandhi and other leaders during the Quit India movement. After arrest the leaders, in spite of severe restriction of the British government, Usha Mehta worked very hard to bring out the truth and make the people aware of the condition prevailing in the Quit India movement. The broadcast was done 2 times a daily, one in the morning at 8:30 and another one in the evening at 8:45. She shifted from one place to another to escape from the hands of the British. It was continued for 88 days. The British appointed a special team for investigation. Later, she was arrested and imprisoned for 4 years. She was interviewed on 11th August 2000. At the age of 80, she mentioned and described her involvement with the Secret Congress Radio as her finest moment, but at the same time, her saddest moment, because an Indian technician had betrayed them to the authorities. Also, she mentioned that her lifetime achievement was Secret Congress restriction. Usha Mehta. Hello, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Audible, ma'am. You continue, ma'am.
Okay. Oh, okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
The women of Tamil Nadu had contributed remarkably in various movements like that Nagpur flag agitation in 1923, Appropriation movement, the removal of Neel statue agitation in 1927, the salt satyagraha in 1930. Individual satyagraha and the Quit India movement in 1942 started for India's freedom. Lot of women participated in this movement from different places in Madras presidency. According to statistical report of 1930, 291 women satyagrahis were arrested from Madras. During the salt satyagraha, countless women participated in the struggle, but their contributions lost in the pages of history. Among them, selected women's contributions we have remembered here. The first one of the female freedom fighter is Ambuja Ammal. She was from Madras. She was Indian independent activist as well as women's rights activist. In Madras, a group of women formed the Women's Sudesi League. She was one of the founders of this league. The primary aim was to encourage hand spinning and weaving. Later, many of the members became trained volunteers in the demonstrations. She was injured in lathi charges by the police. The members of this league were also active in picketing foreign club. Ambuja Ammal stood out as one of the foremost women from the south who picked foreign club in Madras. Later, she was arrested. Also, she participated in the civil disobedience movement and the Quit India movement. During the Quit India movement started, the voluntary corps of Madras to help the refugees with food and shelter. She was secretary of the Women's Indian Association from 1939 to 47. Then she served as vice president of the Tamil Nadu National Congress 1957-62. She was awarded the Padma Shri in 1964. The next one of the female freedom fighter, Anjali Ammal. She was from Kadalur. She was a social worker. She started her political activism in 1921. She was the first woman from South India to take part in the non-cooperation movement in 1921. She sold her family lands, her house, and spent the money for India's struggle for freedom. She took part in the removal of Neel Satyagraha, foreign club boycott, salt satyagraha, toddy shop picketing, individual satyagraha and Quit India movement. During the removal of Neel Satyagraha, Anjali Ammal and her daughter Akkam Ammal participated. She encouraged her daughter, at the time 9-year-old daughter Akkam Ammal, to participate in the protest. Both were arrested and sentenced to imprisonment. Amma Kamal was sent to children's home at Madras at the time when Gandhi came to Kadalur to meet Anjali Ammal. The British government prohibited him their meet, but Anjali Ammal still managed to meet him by dressing up in a burqa. Her courage was well known that Mahatma Gandhi called her South India's Jhansi Rani. Here I would like to mention one thing. Gandhiji had often praised South Indian women freedom fighters in comparison with Jhansi Rani. If he had known the bravery of Velu Nachiyar, he would have praised these women fighters in comparison with Rani Sivaganga or Rani Velu Nachiyar. Okay, come to the point. In 1931, she presided over the All India Women Congress meet. After independence, she elected as the member of the Tamil Nadu Legislative Assembly thrice. She took part in Salt Satyagraha struggle, for which she was sent to Vellore prison. She was released on bail on account of her delivery. Within 2 weeks after her son was born, she was sent back to the Vellore prison. Totally, she had undergone 5 years of imprisonment for these activities. Then is one of the unsung female freedom fighters. Dear participants, if you have any queries, kindly post in chat box. At the end of the session, I will clarify that. Turkabai Deshmukh. She was born in Kakinada from Madras Presidency. At the age of 12, she dedicated herself for the service of the nation. During Gandhiji's visit to Godavari, she donated her entire jewels to the Satyagraha Fund. On 25th April 1930, during the salt Satyagraha, Turgabai reached the seashore to produce salt with 1,000 volunteers accompanied. At that time, 100 police surrounded the females and having swearing them, belabored them brutally. They were beaten and forcibly dragged and sustained injuries. She was arrested and sentenced to 3 months imprisonment. Then she founded Andhra Mahila Sabha in 1937. She was a multitasking personality like lawyer, social worker, and politician and freedom fighter. Then there's one of the unsung female heroine, A.P. Janaki Ammal. She was from Madurai, 1924. She entered the Congress Party. She was the vice president of the Tamil Nadu Actors Association. She participated in the Salt Satyagraha. She was arrested and imprisoned. She is known as the first South Tamil Nadu to be arrested by the British in 1930. In 1936, she became a full-time Congress activist. In 1936, she worked as the office bearer in the Madurai Congress Committee. After the party split, she moved to Communist Party of India. During the emergency, she sold off the jewelry and the silk cloth to raise money for food for party caterers. She was one of the active political members of the individual Satyagraha movement. She was arrested for her anti-war propaganda in Tirchi. She was founder of the Tamil Nadu Democratic Women's Association. That is one of the unsung female freedom fighter, V.M. Kodai Nayaki Ammal. Chandrakuttu was a feminist and a freedom fighter. She was a member of the Madras District Congress Committee. She was a public speaker for the Congress Party, Tamil writer, novelist, journalist, and a classical musical singer. She was the first woman to occupy the editorial board of a Tamil magazine. She wrote 115 books and published a monthly Tamil magazine, Jagan Mohini. In 1937, she established a printing press. She participated in the Satyagraha agitation against toddy shop and liquor shop and was arrested by the police and sentenced to 8 months. After Gandhi was assassinated, she started an association called Mahatma Gandhi Seva Sangha to help poor and urban children. Next one of the unsung heroine, Moovallur Ramamirram. She was from Tanjore. She was closely associated with the Devadasi system. She was brought up in a Devadasi family in Moovallur village in Tanjore. She came out from that evil bravely, fought for the abolition of evil practice. Ramamindam's political career began in the Congress. After meeting Gandhiji at Mayuram in 1921, she became a Congress propagandist. Participated in the non-cooperation movement at the village level within Congress. Later, she allied herself with Periyar E.V. Ramaswamy. She wrote Dasigal Mosavalai or Minor Crown Rise. The book brought mass awareness among public. Kudiyarasu also supported to abolish Devadasi system. She headed dhoti wearing agitation for repressor classes. While she was staging a play on abolition of Devadasi system, she was tortured by cutting her hair. In fact, her dream came true during her lifetime as the act was passed in 1947, that is abolition of Devadasi system. The next one of the unknown female freedom fighter, Raglat Ammal. Raglat Ammal from Kovilpatti. She was an active participant of the Salt Satyagraha. She was joined in the national movement in 1920, also participated in the non-cooperation movement. She was an active participant of the Salt Satyagraha and arrested and quoted imprisonment. The next one of the female freedom fighter, Rukmani Lakshmipathi. All of us know about Rukmani Lakshmipathi. She was the vice president of Tamil Nadu Congress, Provincial Congress Committee, accompanied to Vedaranyam Salt Satyagraha. Day before yesterday, Professor Anand Silvarasa mentioned also about her. Rajaji was arrested by British. During that time, Rukmani Lakshmipathi presided over the Vedaranyam Salt Satyagraha. She was arrested and sentenced for 1 year. All of us know, so I skip the slide. The next one of the content, Gandhi's constructive program. Gandhi's call to women of Madras presidency to participate in various programs like picketing liquor shops, promotion of Khadi, Sudesi movement, foreign cloth boycott, and received good response from women. First, one of the women participants, the Gandhi's constructive program, Pichamuthu Ammal. Pichamuthu Ammal, an Indian Christian, a medical practitioner at Mission Hospital for 13 years, had her higher education for 60 years of London. She joined the Congress Party in the 1920s. In the 1930s, she became the president of Tamil Nadu Congress Party. It was during her presidentship, more than 2,000 volunteers entered jail within 3.5 months. During the Salt Satyagraha, she was arrested and imprisoned for 1 year. She was also the secretary of the Sahodarigal Sangam in Madurai. Sahodarigal Sangam mobilized women for the Congress activities, particularly for khadi spinning and selling and for organizing foreign cloth boycotts. The Sangam was organized by the noticed women nationalities at Madurai. Thayar Ammal, Sita Lakshmi Ammal, Padmashni Ammal, Pichamuthu Ammal, and Subbalakshmi Ammal. They contributed money and ornaments to Swaraj Fund. The next one of the female freedom fighters, E.V. Ramaswamy Nayaka, wife Nagammal and his sister Kannammal. E.V.R.C. Rajagopalacharya organized a group of volunteers known as Thondar Padai to picket liquor shops in the Madras presidency. The government started action against leaders like Periyar and Rajaji like that. They were imprisoned. Thereafter, women like Periyar's wife Nagammal and his sister Kannammal took over the leadership of the picketing liquor shop agitation and pursued the movement at Erode. Inspired by Nagammal and Kannammal, a number of women from Erode participated in the agitation. So, sensing the seriousness of the situation, the government lifted the ban under section 144 of Criminal Penal Code. When the liquor shop was closed, revenue for the government would be affected. At present, we are facing same situation today. Okay, control the point. Then the Congress, the time when the Congress asked Gandhiji to stop the Erode agitation. For that, he says that the things are not in my hands and that the agitation is in the hands of two women from Erode, namely Nagammal and Kannammal. They actively participated in the freedom movement, in the Gandhi's constructive programs. The next, contribution of Tamil freedom fighters in INO. Many of us know of what Lakshmi Swaminathan. Yesterday's session also Madam Thangam mentioned the book, so I skipped this video. The revolutionary of the Indian independent movement, she was officer of the Indian National Army, the Minister of Women's Affairs and the Azad Hind government, in charge of establishing and leading the Rani of Jhansi regiment. She was called Lakshmi when taken prisoner in Burma during the Second World War. She is known as Captain of Lakshmi. That time, several women sepoys were served in the INA. Next to Lakshmi, Janaki Adi from Madurai. She was an actively participated role in Rani of Jhansi Regiment. There were many women sipais from Madras in the Indian National Army. They were Chinnammal, Subaranchidam, Rukmani, Velayammal, Radhammal, Pattammal and Jayalashmi from Madras and Angammal from Madurai. They served in Indian National Army as a sipai with regimental number 8240 in Rani of Jhansi Regiment. Saraswati Ammal, Dhanabakyam, Lakshmi Devi, Meenakshi from Thanjavur, Chinnammal and Kamachi Ammal of Manamadurai, Govindammal of Chelam, Palaniyai Ammal of Tirchi, Sangamalai Ammal of Tirunelveli, Pattammal from South Arkad, served the INA. The next one of the Indian National Army, Gandhi Medibai. Gandhi Medibai was a sipai on Indian National from Ramnad district. 16th data recently newspaper, 16th data newspaper recently published a unsung women sipai who served in Netaji's army. She served as a sipai of Balasena at the age of 12. She joined in Balasena. This picture, she was served in INA. Due to age ailment, she was died on 16th July 2020. In fact, Indian women, particularly such a unknown South Indian women, women personalities actively, bravely served in the Indian National Army for independence. I have recorded a selected number of unsung female from freedom fighters before you. As I conclude, today we have remembered several unsung, unknown, unseen faces and unheard voices of female freedom fighters of India. The few frontline women freedom fighters who made it into history books invariably came from elite or middle class backgrounds, and their male relatives had often encouraged them to join the movement. In contrast, there were innumerable ordinary women with no formal education, very little schooling, hailing from poverty stricken conservative homes, who got involved in the struggle with undaunted spirit and great commitment. Like these women never found the pages of history. Although the government have had parks, roads, memorial stamps for freedom fighters, even though the lack of the presence of ordinary women in historical work. We are faculty members, so we know history writing is generally based on official records. At this juncture, it is our responsibility to recommend the education department to prescribe these unsung female freedom fighters in textbooks. We also encourage the research scholars to do research on those great personalities. Nowadays, these personalities are unearthed by historians little by little. Assure today the unsung heroines who are lost in the pages of history definitely may come great celebrities in the pages of freedom fighters' history. Thank you, sir. As we are running short of time, I can answer selected questions only. First one. Shall I say the answer, sir?
Yes, madam. Yes,
okay,
madam.
Okay, sir. What are the sources available to write this unsung heroine's history? Very good question. Both sources are available, primary and secondary sources. British military consultancy records, government orders, fortnightly report, newspapers, then statistical report, as well as literary sources also. So also that professor, please refer in concerned districts state archives. Thank you. one professor asked, is there any source to know about Quili? As far as I am concerned, according to military consultancy records mentioned, Udayar Women's Army. The name Quili is not mentioned in historical records. Tamil Nadu government erected a memorial for Quili, that is creative source is there. Thank you, sir. The next one participant asked, have any Indian Christian women participated in freedom movement? Also, one of the friend asked, any Muslim women participated? I consulted the both questions. Of course, Maryam Bibi was a Muslim woman from Tirchi. She participated in Nagpur flag agitation in 1923. She traveled, then participated, arrested, and imprisoned in Kadalur jail for 6 months. As well as Indian Christian women. Also, I mentioned the several women's names. Ignatius Ammal, Anthony Ammal, Raclette Ammal, Pitsamuth Ammal were Indian Christians. They actively participated and were arrested and imprisoned. Indian women who joined the national movement from all caste and all religion, they gave their lives to ensure us freedom. Thank you. Then next one of the question, Usha Mehta's history was darkened by Congress. Why? I mean, because of political reason, we can't discuss in this forum. We'll discuss in another forum, sir. Next. Moovallur Ramamrutham was related into Devadasi system and the self-respect movement. How was she connected in the freedom movement? Yeah. With Gandhi's visit at Mayuram in Tanjore, she met him and joined the non-cooperation movement. Later, she allied with Periyar to fight the social evils. The last question. Was there any other radio broadcast other than the Secret Congress Radio? Yeah. The Secret Congress Radio was run by Usha Mehta in India. At the same time, Azad Hind Radio was run by Netaji in Singapore, then later, first Germany, then Singapore, then later Hong Kong. Thank you, sir. Thank you for this opportunity. Once again, I thank the panelists and the dear friends for being patiently participated. Thank you for opportunity, sir. Thank you, sir.
My dear historians, this is our program for today. Tomorrow is the 7th day. We are conclude the faculty development program. There is one announcement. Please kindly note all the process, faculty members and scholars. In this new guidelines of UGC, there is any faculty program will be conducted. There is a assessment for the program is very must and essential one. In this regarding, we are having assessment for our program. The final day, the faculty development program tomorrow. So we have an assessment. In the assessment, whenever resource persons, they are taking classes, presentation for these 6 days. In these days, the presentation from our presenters, we are asking few questions 10 to 15 questions we are prepared. It will be posted tomorrow. All the participants and the professors, research scholars, kindly submit the assessment form for issuing a certificate regarding. It is not a test. It is only assessment for giving certificate as per the guidelines of MHRD. So kindly note, my dear professors and research scholars. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir. Now I invite Mr. P. Saravanan, Superintendent of Kamaraj College, Thoothukudi, to propose the vote of thanks. Welcome you, sir.
A very good afternoon to all. First of all, I wish to thank Lord Almighty who has showered his blessings to unite us all in this pandemic condition. I also remember with gratitude the architects and inventors who have rendered their life for the invention of such wonderful platforms like Zoom, which has made the world to be in our hands. On behalf of Kamaraj College and the entire fraternity, it is my great pleasure to thank everyone who has made this session a successful one. Now I express my bunch of thanks to Dr. R. Crystal Jiba, Assistant Professor PG and Research Department of History, Government Arts College, Melur, for giving an excellent coverage over today's topic, the unsung heroines of Indian freedom movement. We are all inspired by our presentation, ma'am. Thankful to you. I take this opportune moment to express my deep gratitude to our most beloved icon, our principal, Sir Dr. D. Nagarajan, convener of this FDP, for his huge interest and support in all of the new ventures. Next, I extend my big thanks to our young and energetic organizing secretary of this FDP, head of the Department of History, Kamaraj College, Dr. A. Devaraj, for his tireless toil. Next, I wish to multiply my thanks to other coordinators, Professor A. Subramanian, Dr. M. H. Ahmed Bilal, for their tremendous efforts. We are grateful to our management for encouraging us to organize such FTPs in this pandemic situation. It is the great time to thank the participants from all over the world for their enthusiastic participation and cooperation. Thank you, one and all. Thank you.
ஆனந்தம் கொண்டாடும் நேரம் கல்வியில் உயர்ந்து நின்றோ கல்லூரியே
சூழல்
சூழல்
வந்து வீசதே
கல்லூரியே
சூழல் மனதே
உக்கள் சூழல்
வாழ்வில்
ஏற்று தந்தவர்
யார்?